Well, with Representative Paul Ryan in Cincinnati tonight, there are some big questions emerging. While Democrats want to paint Congressman Ryan as someone who wants to recklessly cut spending, is he? Or is the congressman actually a big-time spender? In our Commitment to Balance News, Ben has the reality check you won't see anywhere else.
Well, we had hoped to sit down with the 7-term Wisconsin congressman and ask him some questions today. Despite our repeated requests, no dice. So what did I want to talk to Congressman Ryan about? Well, how about his spending record? For someone who has been deemed a great fiscal conservative, his recent history could prove otherwise. Go back a short 4 years to 2008, and Congressman Ryan was one of the lead voices pushing Republicans to vote for TARP. Remember TARP, the $700 billion bailout of Wall Street firms like Lehman Brothers? The big spending TARP bill that was the inspiration for the Tea Party in 2010 after lawmakers began bailing out financial firms. So here's a clip of Congressman Ryan in 2008 on the House floor making his case for TARP.
When Secretary Paulson came to us about a week ago, he gave us a 3-page bill that said, give me a blank checkbook and put $700 billion in it. I was offended at that time. And so what happened since then? We added 107 pages of taxpayer protection to that bill. We understand the gravity of this situation, and we worked with our colleagues on the other side to make this bill a better bill. We made sure that there's an insurance program that makes sure that Wall Street shares in the cost of this recovery plan. And we also made sure that the executives of these companies that made these bad bets don't profit from this rescue recovery plan.
But that wasn't true. Despite Ryan's promises that none of this taxpayer money would go to line the pockets of those who created this mess, it did. The New York Attorney General's office published a report on that bailout money in 2009. And the New York Times printed some of the report stating, quote, 9 of the financial firms that were among the largest recipients of federal bailout money paid about 5,000 of their traders and bankers bonuses of more than $1 million apiece for 2008. But the Wall Street crisis was an unusual situation, right? Well, maybe, but Ryan didn't just vote for TARP in 2008. A few months later, he also voted for the auto industry bailout. He voted for Medicare Part D, the largest expansion of Medicare in history. He voted for the massive highway bill that included that famous Bridge to Nowhere. And in 2001, he voted for the airline industry bailout. So what does Paul Ryan really believe? Does he believe that companies are too big to fail in some cases? In fairness, Governor Mitt Romney also supported TARP. Then-Senator Barack Obama voted for it, as did then-Senator Joe Biden. Both Obama and Biden also backed the auto bailout as well. But Ryan is supposed to be the alternative to big spending. Still, the core of what I wanted to ask the congressman about today, this last piece of that sound from 2008.
Madam Speaker, this bill offends my principles. But I'm going to vote for this bill in order to preserve my principles, in order to preserve this free enterprise system.
This bill offends my principles, but I'm going to vote for this bill to preserve my principles. What you need to know, what I'd like to know, what does that even mean? President Bush at the same time said that he abandoned free market principles to save the free market system. So how does that work? Congressman Ryan, which principle did you preserve by voting for TARP? What other principles can be preserved by abandoning them? I'd really like to know. And that is Reality Check.
If you'd like to make your voice heard in the story, you can head over to Ben's Facebook page. Find it by simply searching Ben Swan, WXIX.